It had been a while since the Great Tournament of Power, which endangered the lives of the universes, where thanks to the almost perfect coordination of Universe 7, they were able to win the Tournament of Power, thus reviving all the universes. Months after that event, the gods would have had a meeting, something that they only did in situations of great importance, and no doubt, after all that had happened, this was definitely it. The 12 gods of destruction had seen that the existence of all the universes fell on a mortal who had too much influence on the decisions of the king of all, Zeno-sama. Besides, he had reminded Zeno-sama about the tournament. Therefore, someone who only made stupid decisions just because he wanted to fight was something that the gods could not continue to allow. Someone like Goku was too much danger for everyone, because at any moment, something like that or worse could happen. Vermuth would tell the others, the Saiyan god Goku, he only wanted the tournament to face very strong beings, but when he saw what he had done, it was too late to repent. He's a danger to everyone. We saw how this mortal is very friendly with Zeno-sama. Anything stupid or not, Zeno-sama will listen to him. Hey, and what do you mean by that, Vermuth? Are you saying we should kill him? That would be too noisy, we can't do that. Immediately, Zeno-sama or Daishinkan would stop feeling Goku's ki, and they would surely come to see what was going on. I don't think we should do that. I think something much better. If we lock him up somewhere, a dimension, a place he can never come out of, we could surely do it. Bills, surprised by those words, even though he appreciated Goku, he thought it was right what the other gods told him, because he perfectly understood the danger that Goku meant for all the universes. And that's why he told them. Once they had told me on Earth there was a room of time, as I had understood that place was another dimension, and that there's only one door that serves as a portal to pass from one side to another. Surely we could get him to go train there, and it would be a perfect opportunity to lock him up. It seems easy, but it'll still be complicated. The gods thought it was a brilliant and excellent idea, so everyone accepted this idea and trusted everything to Bills. Some time would pass, and Bills would go to visit the Earth, first going to Vegeta, and he told him that he had to tell him something important. Both go to another place where nobody would hear, because Piccolo was near and could easily have heard this. So once they were alone, Bills told him, "Vegeta, you must do what I'm going to tell you. You have to understand, Goku is a living danger to all universes, and that's why we have to get rid of him." "Wait, Bills, what are you talking about? How the hell do you think you're going to get rid of Kakarot? Don't you appreciate him?" "Vegeta, this goes beyond sentiment or appreciation. We're talking about the universes. I only ask you to help Goku enter the room of time. We have to lock him inside and destroy the door so that he never comes out again, and we can avoid so many problems in the future." "What are you talking about, Bills? I won't do that to Kakarot. Despite all the fights, he's my friend, and I don't have to do it." "Damn, Vegeta. I knew you would say this. That's why you decide. Sacrifice the planet or lock Goku inside. Do you want to die and take your whole family with you?" "No, Bills, why are you doing this to me? I could not do that to Kakarot." "But I'm obliged to do it. If not, you'll destroy everything. Besides, I think I understand everything, and you are right in what you mentioned about Goku. I'll do my best to lock him in that room." At that moment, Bills would go to his planet, and Vegeta would tell everything to Bulma and everyone else, except Chi-Chi, Gohan, and Goten. None of his friends agreed to lock Goku up, but they finally convinced them. It was either the planet would be destroyed, or Goku had to be locked up. It was clear that the planet was the priority. Plus, they knew that Goku was nothing but trouble. After everyone acknowledged it, Vegeta would go to Goku and tell him to train in the hyperbolic time chamber. But Goku had already trained a lot and would tell Vegeta he did not feel like going to that place because he already felt comfortable and confident with his power. So Vegeta told him he has not yet managed to control and master the egoistic doctrine. So Goku would tell him that it would not be necessary, but Vegeta reminded him that enemies could appear much stronger than Jiren and that they haven't seen the strongest and had to be prepared for new threats. After Goku heard those words, he would go with Vegeta to the hyperbolic time chamber, where both would enter to train. The two would be training, thanks to the fact that they had to become much stronger, as Vegeta told Goku, so that they would continue for a long time. But as the months passed inside the room, Vegeta would tell Goku that he would go out for a few moments, but then he would return. Goku would say that he would wait until he returned to continue training, but this was nothing more than a lie from Vegeta to finally leave Goku alone in the room. So he would leave the place, and at the moment of leaving, he would destroy the entrance of the Room of Time with a blast of energy, making the small point that interconnected them disappear. Which would make Goku get locked inside the room. Goku would not notice this, as he was far away from the entrance, practicing one of his techniques. But he saw that for some reason, Vegeta was taking longer than he should. Goku would understand that something was not right, but he left it like that, until much more time passed and Vegeta still did not return, thus piquing Goku's curiosity. So he went to the entrance of the room to go out and look for Vegeta, but at that moment, he realized that something was very wrong. Realizing that the door was completely destroyed, and that made it impossible to leave the place. Goku, at no time would the thought cross his mind that it was Vegeta, but nevertheless believed that it was himself that did it, by some oversight while he was practicing. But after much thought, he realized he had not done it at any time, because he would have realized. So he had no choice but to believe that this was an act of Vegeta. While outside the room, Vegeta said, "It cost me to do it, but I was finally able to lock him up. I hope he doesn't hate me for doing this to him. You did very well, Vegeta. You were able to save this planet, and that's the most important thing." On the other hand, in the room, Goku was still confused and thought to himself, "Vegeta, why would you do that to me? Why lock me in this damn place? So you just told me all this to lock me up? I swear I will get revenge." Goku realized Vegeta's betrayal, locking him inside the hyperbolic time chamber, and Goku got angry because he didn't understand the reason. "Why did you do this to me, Vegeta? Why did you do it? I don't understand." "No, wait, I don't think Vegeta did it by himself. He'd have no reason to do it. A lot of people don't seem to like him, but knowing Vegeta, they had to have blackmailed him with something. I don't know, but they'll all pay for this if I ever get out of this damn place. What reason did they have to do this to me? I've given everything for them. I've sacrificed myself many times to save them. I have always fought to save them. It's not fair. I gave them everything and they stabbed me in the back. They had no right to betray me this way. When I get out of this place, they'll wish they had never locked me up." After this, months would pass in which Goku was just beginning to master the Ultra Instinct. By this time, the food supplies were starting to run low, and there was only enough left for 2 days. Goku knew he would have to leave or he would die. "I have to do it. I will increase all my power to get out of this place. I think with all the power I have, it'll be enough to open other portals." That said, Goku would increase his power more and more, starting with the classic Saiyan, until reaching the blue phase, and finally making his technique more powerful. So he would do the maximum Kaioken as far as he could, making the whole place tremble. The whole place seemed to crack, but this was nothing more than an illusion. The place was intact, and not even the slightest hint of a portal was formed. Goku was surprised and frustrated, and thought, "How is it possible that nothing happened? With all the power I used, it was much more than I thought I needed to get out of this place. But why, even using all my power, is nothing happening? I don't understand. A long time ago, Majin Buu did the same thing and was able to get out of this damn place, and that power he had is much lower than the one I have now. It's impossible that nothing happened. Wait, now I remember. He told me he improved the Room of Time, but I didn't think it was this much better. Even using divine power, I'm not able to make a scratch on this room." "Damn," Goku said to himself, extremely frustrated. Meanwhile, outside the hyperbolic time chamber, Chi-Chi would have started looking for Goku, as Goku didn't appear in a long time, which was too weird for her. Gohan and Goten tried to search for his ki, but it was impossible. This made them believe that Goku had died, since they couldn't feel his ki as always. But suddenly, Kaio-sama would contact Gohan, and he would tell him that Goku had been locked inside the hyperbolic time chamber, and that it was impossible for him to get out of that place, since he had already tried in every way. Gohan was speechless and asked Kaio-sama, "Tell me who did it and why. Please tell me." Kaio-sama refused to provide this information to Gohan, as he also did not want to harm those involved. Plus, Beerus might find out about what Kaio-sama did and retaliate against him. "Gohan, the only thing I can tell you is that you have to do something so that your father can survive in that place for as long as necessary. I trust you will find a solution, but don't let your father die in that place." "I'll save him. Thanks for the heads up, Kaio-sama. I owe you one." After the conversation was over, Gohan told Chi-Chi and Goten everything. Goten reminded his brother Gohan about the Dragon Balls, so that he could use them to wish for his father to live forever. "That's what we'll do, Goten. I was planning to do that too." They would go in search of the Dragon Balls, but they would realize that Bulma had already collected them again, so they asked Bulma if she could please lend them the Dragon Balls to ask for a wish. Gohan didn't know that Bulma was involved in all of this. Bulma refused to lend them, but Bulma got distracted and Goten took them from her. They went to another place to summon Shenlong with the balls. They summoned the dragon and it appeared, asking, "Tell me what your wish is." Gohan came up with a better idea and asked Shenlong to make Goku appear in that place. But Shenlong would tell him that it was impossible because he was out of his limits, since he was basically in another dimension. So, Gohan opted for the second option, and he would tell him to make Goku immortal. The dragon fulfilled his wish, and Goku got immortality. At that moment, Goku felt a strange sensation through his body. By that time, Goku had already passed a few days without eating, and it was affecting him a lot. But suddenly, those problems disappeared, because he started to feel as if he didn't need any of that. Goku did not understand what had happened to him, but it's obvious he would later realize it. 2 years would pass, in which Goku still felt nothing, and he understood that, somehow, they made him become immortal. 10 years passed, and Goku mastered and even perfected the Ultra Instinct. Outside the room, only 10 days would have passed. Vegeta said to himself, "Kakarot must be dead by now. In that place, a decade must have already passed." Inside the room, time would continue to pass as it always used to be, and so 100 years would pass, in which Goku had already reached a new transformation, and had a power that surpassed even the gods. Likewise, the power was enough to fight against an angel. At that moment, Goku's ambition and resentment was already so great that he could have used all his power to leave the Room of Time, but he chose not to, because he wanted even more power. By this time, Goku's way of thinking was already totally different, as he would have become a more serious and calculating person. Something in Goku was different. The naive Goku of before had disappeared. "Now, not even Beerus himself will be able to cope with my power. Neither could Whis, and soon, I'll be more powerful than even Dai Shenkan, and I'll be the strongest being in the multiverse." Goku had more than 100 years inside the hyperbolic time chamber, and had reached a very powerful stage that surpasses all gods and angels. Goku would prefer to stay longer in that place, since he wanted to be superior to everyone, even superior to Dai Shenkan and Zeno-sama himself. Outside the room, after 100 days had passed on Earth, Bulma and the others assumed that Goku should have already died in that place. So they already accepted this fact, even though they had all loved Goku at the time, but they knew among themselves that accepting his death was something totally necessary. In the end, Goku was still a problem, and they resorted to the best way they could to hide it. In another place, Zeno-sama had been requesting Goku's presence for days to ask him for something and to play with him. Zeno-sama had not seen the Saiyan for a long time, so after all that time, he wanted to see him. Zeno-sama asked Daishinkan why Goku had not come if he had already asked him to visit. Daishinkan told Zeno-sama that he would take care of that. So Daishinkan went to Kaioshin of Universe 7 and asked him to see to it that Goku was at Zeno-sama's palace as soon as possible, because Zeno-sama wanted to see him. Kaioshin told Daishinkan that he would do so. However, Kaioshin did not know about what had been done to Goku by the destroyer god Beerus and the others. So after talking to Daishinkan, he went to his universe to warn Goku about Zeno-sama. Kaioshin tried to find Goku's key to appear in front of him, but despite all of his efforts, he could not even feel a bit of Goku's energy. "Why don't I feel Son Goku's energy? I've always felt it all the time, but now I try to look for his key, it's impossible for me to find it. How strange. Did something happen to Goku? I'd better go to Earth and see where Goku is." After thinking about it, Kaioshin went to Earth in search of answers. So he went to Bulma, Vegeta, and the others to ask them where Goku was, because Zeno-sama requested his presence, and he might get angry. Vegeta was frightened by this, but Vegeta told Kaioshin, "If you ask about Kakarot, he recently went to train in the hyperbolic time chamber, because he said he wanted to become much stronger, and will be away for a while in that place," said Vegeta. After hearing this, Kaioshin understood why he did not feel Goku's ki, since Goku was in another dimension, and his capabilities did not reach that level. So he said to Vegeta, "Okay, I'll head to Kami's tower to go to that place. Zeno-sama can't wait." Vegeta was frightened by what Kaioshin said, because if he went to that place, he would notice the door to the hyperbolic time chamber had been destroyed, and would surely tell Daishinkan, who would then tell Zeno-sama, and Zeno-sama might get extremely angry. "No, no, wait, don't bother him. He said not to interrupt him, no matter what was going on. You know Kakarot, he doesn't like to be disturbed while he's training," Vegeta said. Kaioshin found it very strange what Vegeta had told him. "Alright, Vegeta," he said. Kaioshin said goodbye to everyone and teleported out of there. Vegeta, Bulma, and the others realized that Kaioshin would not listen to them, and that he would surely go to the hyperbolic time chamber to find Goku. So they had no choice but to bring Beerus to prevent Kaioshin from saying anything to Zeno-sama or Daishinkan. Meanwhile, Kaioshin arrived at Kami's tower, but found that the door to the hyperbolic time chamber was completely destroyed. He found that the attack that destroyed the door was made from the outside. But what happened to the entrance to the room? Did they purposefully destroy the entrance and exit of this place? What the heck happened? Wait, now I get it. That's why Vegeta sounds so nervous when I told him I was going to this place. He must have locked him in here. But why? I don't get it. Vegeta was very stupid by telling me about Goku being here. Maybe he didn't think I would come, but his assumptions were wrong. Kaioshin, after seeing this, tried to help Goku by telling Daishinkan about this. But before he could even move to leave the planet Earth, Beerus appeared in front of Kaioshin. "Mr. Beerus, what are you doing here? Did you also come to visit Saiyan Goku? Wait, why are you looking at me like that?" "Don't tell me you're involved in all this. It's not possible," said Kaioshin. "That's right, I've come here to prevent you from telling anyone else about this. If you do, you will pay dearly. I can't threaten you with death, because I depend on you to live, but I can do much worse things to you than death. So don't even think of saying a single word of this to anyone. You will simply tell Zeno-sama that Goku is training, and that he will soon visit him in his palace. Do you understand me?" Kaioshin had no choice but to accept this. He went to Daishinkan and told him that Goku could not come to visit Zeno-sama because he was too busy training, but that soon he would come to visit him. Daishinkan told this to Zeno-sama, and Kaioshin of Universe 7 left the place without further ado. Thanks to this, those of Universe 7 were saved from suffering the wrath of Zeno-sama, which would surely have ended very badly. Zeno-sama, after what Daishinkan told him, preferred to wait for Goku to finish his training so as not to disturb him. Meanwhile, Goku in the hyperbolic time chamber would continue training non-stop. He would spend 1,000 years in that place. Goku already had a power that was practically unattainable, even for Zeno-sama himself. Goku's power was something unimaginable, even for the most powerful deities of the universe. By this time, Goku already had more than enough power to end the life of any being in existence. He had reached a state where what he had been 1,000 years ago no longer existed completely. Spending 1,000 years there without having contact with any individual caused him to have a much more independent and precise way of thinking. He would have learned and created many secret techniques that only he had. It had been long enough for Goku to feel like leaving there. "Now my power is superior to any being in existence. They will pay for what they did to me. I will not forget it. I've been in this place for centuries, in complete solitude. That's not made me forget the betrayal of the people who were supposed to be my friends. I see things differently now. I can't even trust myself. Why would I trust others? The only truth is that no matter what you do for them, they will only see the bad and negative side of things. Therefore, I will stand alone from now on. And he who wants to stand against my power will pay for it with his life. I've had enough of this place. It's not easy to look around you and see there's absolutely nothing, just empty space." Determined to leave, Goku began to increase his power more and more until... So, by increasing all his power, it only took him a few moments to make the whole room of time collapse and open infinite portals, which led to thousands of dimensions and different universes. The fact that there were so many dimensional and universal portals did not affect Goku at all, because thanks to that connection, he could feel the ki of someone from his own universe in one of the portals for some reason. That ki was from Gohan, who was training with Goten, and Goten was increasing his power. Thanks to this, Goku would teleport to where Gohan and Goten were training. Goku appeared in front of Gohan, and he turned around and saw his father in front of him. This left Gohan speechless, and he would be very surprised to see all this, just like Goten. "Dad, you're alive! I didn't think you were. Even though I asked Shenlong to make you immortal, I didn't believe you were alive. How is it possible? It's been almost 4 years, and I haven't heard from you. Wait, were you in there for 1,000 years? Asked Gohan. "It's been over 1,000 years, Gohan, since the last time I saw you. All that was an infinite eternity," said Goku. "But every one of those years and days I was inside that place, I always remembered how my own friends betrayed me. I wanted to destroy everything around me every time that thought came to my mind. I had given them my trust, my very life, and I only received a direct stab in the back. Because of that, every one of those who betrayed me will pay for it. First, I'll go after Vegeta. Let's see what that bastard has to say." "Father, what do you mean? Are you saying that Vegeta was the one who locked you in there?" "No, he couldn't have. Kai talked to me, and thanks to that, I was able to make you immortal with the Dragon Balls. He didn't want to tell me who the ones were that had done all this to you. I suspected everyone but Vegeta. Why would he do that? It doesn't make any sense. Why do it at that moment, if he could have done it much earlier?" "Gohan, what matters is that he betrayed me, and he will pay for that." "Father, don't do it. You don't deserve to do this. Please, I beg you, don't kill him. You already forgave him once. It wouldn't be that hard for you to do it again. Even though I hate him now for what he did, I don't think you should hurt Vegeta. Surely he must have had his reasons."
"Shut up, Gohan. I don't care now what you tell me. I don't care what anyone tells me right now. In the end, everyone knows how to stab in the back and destroy my trust. I was also able to tell Kai, even though I was locked inside the room, and he told me who was behind all this." At that moment, Goku was about to go to Vegeta, but Gohan, in Super Saiyan mode, with all his might, tried to stop Goku from doing that. This made Goku angry.
"I told you to stay out of it," said Goku. Goku easily brushed Gohan off, threw him against some rocks, and left, leaving Goten stunned by what he had just witnessed.
"What happened to my father? He's not even a shadow of his former self. I don't recognize him now," said Gohan.
Meanwhile, Goku quickly arrived at Vegeta, who was with Bulma. Goku appeared in front of Vegeta. Both Vegeta and Bulma could not believe what they were seeing. They thought it was someone with the same appearance as Goku, but realized later it was in fact the real Goku.
"What? This is impossible. Kakarot should have died long ago in that place.
How is it possible he's still alive? He must have run out of food there. And besides, 1,000 years have already passed. This can't be real. Are you really Kakarot? Why am I shaking? What's wrong with me?
Vegeta, I've waited for this moment for a long time, said Goku. I spent all this time remembering over and over again what you did to me. I could never forget it. How could I? That was the reason I spent over 1,000 years in that disgusting place. I know who was involved in my imprisonment, and every one of them will pay for it. At that moment, Vegeta realized that Goku did not come with good intentions, and told Bulma, "Get away from this place as fast as possible, please, you don't belong here." Bulma ignored what Vegeta said, but she thought she could explain things to Goku and fix everything. This turned out to be a terrible mistake. Goku, far from even answering her, stared her in the eyes with a great fury and coldness that made Bulma understand that her words would not help at all. Goku was about to hit Bulma, but at that moment, Vegeta quickly stopped Goku. "I told you to get out of here, stupid. Don't you understand?" said Vegeta. Bulma, after seeing all this, listened to Vegeta and fled the scene, leaving Goku and Vegeta alone. "I won't let you do anything to her, Kakarot. What the hell is wrong with you? And how come you're still alive? You should have died a long time ago." "Vegeta, to your surprise, they made me immortal. So despite the time I spent inside that place, it didn't have any effect on me. And thanks to my immortality, I didn't need to consume food to survive either. But let me tell you, you were very stupid. Why would you lock me up and then allow them to make me immortal? You're an idiot, Vegeta. If you're going to betray me, at least do it right, you bastard." "But how? When did all that happen?" "Wait, don't tell me that was the reason Gohan was asking Bulma for the balls. We were so naive." "Vegeta, finally, after a long time, the time has come for you to pay for everything." "Kakarot, what are you saying? You don't have to do this. I only followed Beerus' orders, you must understand. If I didn't, he would destroy planet Earth, and you know that none of us would want that." "Damn, Vegeta, you should have discussed that with me first. Instead, you chose the easiest option, to betray me and lock me inside there so that I'd never come out. I know that all this, in principle, was planned by all the gods of destruction, and they too will get what they deserve later," said Goku. "Then I have no choice. I see, Kakarot, so you want to fight. I've also increased my power a lot, if you don't believe it. I'll take away that confidence from you, you damn insect." Vegeta was about to attack Goku, but he would stop instantly because he felt a deep fear. Out of nowhere, Vegeta began to sweat from fear. Vegeta did not understand what was happening. However, this was an involuntary reaction of his body towards the immeasurable power of the Saiyan. "What's wrong with me? Why am I so afraid? What's going on?"
Vegeta was about to attack Goku, but before he could do it, his body stopped almost unconsciously, as he realized that something in Goku was different. Goku did not know why Vegeta stopped. Goku saw that Vegeta did not attack him at the last moment and said,
"What's the matter, Vegeta? Weren't you planning to attack me? Tell me, Vegeta, are you afraid?"
Vegeta, upon hearing this, could not with his pride, and said, "Shut up, damn you! Do you think I'm afraid of you, you insect? What the hell are you saying, Kakarot? I'll show you I'm much stronger than you, you idiot!" Vegeta couldn't take it anymore and attacked Goku, but this time, despite Vegeta's feeling of inferiority, he continued to attack. He hit him many times, but Goku didn't even move and seemed to be unaffected. Goku in his base state was superior to Vegeta in his transformation of the Super Saiyan Blue God. Vegeta saw that Goku hadn't even flinched from transforming, and that in his base state he wasn't taking any damage from his attacks.
"But how? That's not possible! The insect hasn't even transformed!"
Goku, after receiving all these blows from Vegeta and not receiving any damage, this in 1,000th of seconds would give a small blow to Vegeta, which would send him flying away from the place, crashing against several nearby rocks.
"No, this can't be! How is he doing all that to me without even transforming? How on earth could he get so powerful?"
Away from the place, the others would realize that there was a huge key far away from that place. and also realized that Vegeta's ki was getting lower and lower. They thought of everyone but Goku. That didn't even cross their minds. But their faces changed when they arrived at the site and saw a wounded Vegeta, while Goku was in front of him.
Wait, this isn't true! It's impossible! Is it Goku? But how? He was dead! How did he survive so long in that time room?
Goku, who was in front of Vegeta, would turn and see his former friends, who were the ones who betrayed him. Krillin would try to explain to Goku about everything, but Goku told him,
"Enough! Don't give me explanations. I know what they did, and that's why they'll pay for it."
What are you saying, Goku? We're still your friends!
They were my friends before they betrayed me, but now they're just garbage to me.
Krillin would realize that no matter what he said, it wasn't going to change Goku's realistic thinking. And he would tell Vegeta,
"How come he did this to you? Can't you beat him? Why? What are we gonna do now? That Goku's not the one I knew years ago. He's completely different."
"I don't know. Kakarot is invincible, and even though I hit him several times, I didn't even tickle him."
"I see. Apparently they didn't repent for what they did. Anyway, it's too late to repent, don't you think? Don't worry. I'll exterminate them very quickly. They won't even suffer, even though they really deserve it." Vegeta saw this and thought,
"No! I can't let Kakarot do this! I must defeat him at any cost! But he's too strong! I can't do anything against him! I have no choice but to try!"
Vegeta increased all his power and reached the state of Blue Transformation Dominated. And with this, all his strength, he would attack Goku. He was managing to give him a good fight, making them both maintain a somewhat even battle. The others were not able to see the speed of the movements of both. Goku, after a few minutes, said to Vegeta,
"You're still far too weak to face me. I was just testing your strength."
Goku increased his power a little more, and so he threw an energy ball at Vegeta, which would be strong enough to leave him badly hurt on the ground, without even being able to move.
"I couldn't do anything. I'm stupid."
"How pathetic, Vegeta. Why face me if you'd end up in such a humiliating way? It's better to wait for imminent death than to try to avoid it by increasing the odds."
"But well, it's time for you to disappear for what you did to me." Goku would make a giant ball of power, which he launched while saying,
"Die!"
This ball of energy was about to hit them, but suddenly that giant sphere would be completely destroyed, which would leave Goku shocked.
"How? Who did it?"
said Goku. In front of Goku, Beerus had appeared, together with Whis, and this god was the one who had destroyed that power.
"So it's you, Beerus. Can't believe you came, after what you caused. Good thing you came, so I don't have to go looking for you myself on your crappy planet."
Whis told him, "Mr. Beerus, what is happening is that he's no longer the Goku we used to know. What you're seeing now is an evolution of Goku after a millennium of training in that place. Now he's much more serious and cold-minded with things. His personality of before has completely disappeared. You must understand, he spent millennia alone in that place. But now it seems he has a lot of anger towards you, and with good reason, Mr. Beerus."
"Now I understand, Whis. Goku, I had to lock you up in that place. It was a request from all the gods of destruction, since your naive attitude at that moment put all the universes at risk. Don't you understand?"
"Beerus, I don't care about your excuses. You shouldn't have done it. And for that, you will all die. If you try to get into this, Whis, you'll share the same fate as him."
This would leave Whis somewhat confused, as the latter still did not know all the power that Goku now had. For his part, Beerus would tell Goku,
"So, I see. You want to face me, Saiyan. I can see it in your eyes."
Beerus at that moment knew that he had to go all out from the beginning, so he would increase all his power, which would shake the Earth completely. Thanks to the barrier that the angel Whis put up, the Earth was not destroyed by the power of the god of destruction, Beerus. Goku was not yet transformed into any transformation, but he would increase his power in his base state completely. Both of them started fighting, and Whis's barrier was not being able to withstand such power, and was starting to be destroyed. Goku said to Beerus,
"If that's all your power, too bad. It's not even going to be enough to make me transform."
"What? What are you saying? In that state, you're more powerful than me? This is impossible! How on earth, in your base form, are you stronger? It doesn't make sense!"
"Beerus, you can do nothing against me. Your inferiority is absolute."
"Shut up, you damn Saiyan! What do you think you're doing, you bastard?"
Beerus at that moment became angry and would release a lot of power, which would end up destroying Whis's barrier completely. And Whis would say,
"You will pay for confronting the god of destruction, so die."
Goku would see all this, and he would seriously tell Beerus, "Stupid, what are you doing this for? If the only thing you're causing is to destroy this beautiful planet, and for what? To defeat me? It is a price you'll not be able to pay, because I'm still superior to you. And the only thing I see before my eyes is an insignificant being that destroys everything for no apparent reason, because he is still weak. Compared to my power, you're totally pathetic. I should have killed you before you caused all this on Earth." Beerus, hearing more of Goku's words, made him lose his reason of rage. And this one, without thinking twice, would launch himself to attack Goku. And this one would manage to hit him. And Beerus really was already seeming to have some advantage over Goku. And this one would not stop giving infinite blows to the Saiyan, without stopping at any time. This was a different Beerus, someone who would let himself be dominated by Fury. While this was happening, the planet Earth began to get destroyed more and more. All living beings on the planet were disappearing, as the entire planet was totally destroyed and the heat that was felt was hellish. The former friends of the Saiyan would try to escape from the place, seeing how it was filled with craters and lava, and they would try to escape in a ship. But when they were close to leaving the planet, a ray of energy would hit the ship, and it would be completely destroyed, thus ending the life of Krillin, 18, Yamcha, Tien Shinhan, and others like Piccolo, who stayed on Earth to share the same fate as the planet. Meanwhile, Beerus was still attacking Goku, but at that moment, Goku closed his eyes and said to him, "That's enough!" Goku at that moment decided to finish Beerus as fast as possible. So Goku would use one of his most powerful transformations. All this Goku did totally calm, while preparing a simple attack. Beerus was perplexed when he observed this transformation of Goku, and realized that Goku was preparing a small technique, something insignificant for Beerus, who didn't worry about it. But the angel, Whis, when he saw this, he looked at the transformation of Goku and was speechless, because he immediately knew that he could do absolutely nothing against Goku, because he was already insurmountable for him. Whis would tell Beerus,
"Mr. Beerus, with that technique will kill you instantly. It looks simple, but inside it contains a large part of your power, which is enough to kill you in an instant."
"Mr. Beerus, please leave this place," said Whis.
Goku in that instance would throw that small spear of power at Beerus, which would not give him time to escape. And his destiny was inevitable. Or that was what he thought. Beerus was a hundredth of a second away from receiving Goku's attack, but Whis had interposed himself to receive the attack and said,
"Mr. Beerus, you must not die. You must continue to fulfill your work as God of Destruction. You must escape.
Goodbye, Mr. Beerus." At that moment, Whis received the attack squarely and disintegrated almost instantly.
"But Whis, why did you do it? It wasn't your duty to protect me.
That damn Goku will pay for what he did."
"But I'm too weak. I can't do anything to him."
Beerus somehow or other was able to escape from the place, performing a technique on Goku which would bind him for a few minutes.
"But what happened? Where did that idiot go? I swear I'll find him and kill him," said Goku.
On the other hand, Bulma and Vegeta managed to escape from the place thanks to Vegeta, who had learned teleportation during the time that Goku was not there. But he had never wanted to use it because it belonged to Goku, and he had no other choice. Vegeta went to the Namekians. On the other hand, Goku left Earth, which was completely destroyed. Goku saw how the Earth was shattered, and this made him think that everyone had died, but he did not know that Vegeta had managed to escape.
"I'm sorry, Chi-Chi, Gohan, Goten, I couldn't do anything to save you. Rest assured that God will disappear."
Goku went in search of Beerus, and after a few minutes, he finally felt the power of Beerus and immediately teleported to that place. But however, before Goku arrived, Beerus had managed to gather all the gods again. Therefore, Goku would arrive at the site and meet all the gods of destruction. The latter was somewhat surprised and said,
"Oh, what a surprise. All together in this place. No doubt they made the job much less difficult for me. So, here you are, Beerus, taking refuge with these scumbags. How pathetic you are! Who would have thought that a god that everyone feared is being defeated by a mortal? And worst of all, the mortal that beat him, thanks to his own stupidity."
"I see that you've become very strong. You were able to leave Beerus in that state. And now I see how stupid we were to think that would be enough. I didn't think we'd have to go this far, but we will kill you, no matter what it costs us with Zeno-sama."
"Mortal stupid, you've surpassed yourself in everything since you escaped from that place, and as gods of destruction, we must eliminate evil from the universes. And at this moment, you're the perfect Saiyan candidate. You'll regret having messed with the gods of destruction."
What are you talking about, you scum? If you think you can defeat me, that's impossible. Even if they all fight against me at the same time, I would have no problem in finishing them off. They're all mere scum to me. I'm even superior to that being they fear so much. The king of everything, Zeno-sama. And I don't intend to do anything against him unless he requires it.
How dare you compare yourself to the great Zeno-sama? You're insolent! How can you use his name and disrespect him? You're an idiot! And on top of that, you say you surpass him. But what a stupid thing to say, mortal. I don't care if you believe me or not. Everyone will still die, so the result is not altered at all. Beerus, about to die from the wounds the Saiyan had inflicted on him, said,
Don't take it lightly. He really is very powerful, and I don't know if he's right in being superior to the king of the whole, Zeno-sama. But he killed Whis.
All the gods, upon hearing this, would be stunned by what Beerus had said, since they couldn't believe that a Saiyan like him killed an angel. The gods after this did not look at Goku in the same way, and viewed him with fear. The death of an angel like Whis only meant the obvious, that perhaps the Saiyan was not lying about what he said.
What is it now, gods? That's right, I myself eliminated that angel. But really, for him, it was not the attack. A stupid thing died in vain saving him, because I'll still kill him. But now, disappointing for someone like him, well, I think I've given you all enough time.
On the other hand, the gods of destruction knew they had to fight, because it was the only option for them. So, they said,
Well, I think we can't do anything. If that mortal killed the angel, what's in store for us? But how on earth did he get so strong in that place by himself? That's impossible!
With that said, the gods increased their powers to the maximum, and rushed together against the Saiyan. Goku transformed into the state of Ultra Instinct Mastered at once, and with this, he even matched Daishin Khan's power. The gods would stop at the sight of Goku's state, which they had previously seen in the Tournament of Power.
Ugh, that state! He just used it without any effort! It's incredible!
Still surprised, they did not know that in that state, Goku was much more powerful than in the same state in the past, so they threw themselves against the Saiyan from all sides. But this would not do any good.
I told you, gods, you're just trash. Even with my Saiyan Blue transformation would be more than enough, but I don't want to humiliate you so much like that, and I decided to use this state.
Goku, at that moment, appeared from Beerus' back and pierced him with his arm, causing Beerus to bleed to death.
What did he just do? It was just a distraction to get close to Beerus and kill him! But how?
Now, which one of you wants to be next?
You damn Saiyan, you're an idiot! Why do you have to do that? Now you pay for that!
I see, Verdmo. You want to be next.
Then die!
At that moment, Goku appeared instantly in front of Verdmo to kill him, but all the gods stepped in to prevent it.
Damn gods, everyone will suffer then.
Goku, without them even realizing it, had left them all on the brink of death.
I told you, gods, you're just plain scum.
What did he just do to us? I can't move my body!
Calm down, now I only need the final attack. What are you gods going to do now?
Goku, in a second, had left all the gods in an unfavorable state, and as he was about to launch his final technique to end the fight, but they obviously wouldn't let him die in that way.
Saiyans, as I have told you, there is no way I will allow you to kill me. I won't make it that easy. Damn mortal, I know you'll never understand, but we did it for the good of the universes. You know that someone like you at that moment was an imminent danger for all the universes, and you had already shown it before, to someone extremely stupid. And if it wasn't for Zeno-sama, we would have killed you. So that's what you should have done at that time. Now it's too late to repent. Now the only one who decides is me. If I want to let you continue living after what you did to me. But now, all I can think about is to end your lives. Saiyan, you can't be so stupid. If you kill us, you would be destroying the divine hierarchy that has been for millions of years in the multiverse. In any case, the one who must die is you. I'm tired of listening to you telling me stupid things. Go away. But at that moment, Vermouth would appear from Goku's back, and he would try to hit him, but Goku would dodge his hit even without seeing him, ducking, leaving Vermouth exposed, which made Goku grab him by the head and drag it on the ground. Goku would leave him on the ground while this would move away, to allow the god Vermouth can get up, But this, at the time of doing so, he felt like something had pierced him, because at that moment, Goku would have impacted a strong blow on him, which pierced a vital point on his body, leaving others stunned. The god Vermouth would fall bleeding to the ground, on the verge of death, as Goku had pierced his heart. But luckily for Vermouth, he was of a race which possessed three hearts. Looks like that wasn't enough to kill you. You're making it harder than Beerus. I'd better make you disappear completely. And in that instant, he would throw it at Vermouth. But one of the gods of destruction would say, "There's only one option to end this, Vermouth." I didn't think that at some point the gods would have to get to this point. Honestly, I'm disgusted to have to do this. But the only way is to do something that maybe we only did once in our lives. And that was when Daishin Khan was training us, and he taught us how to do that technique. And when we learned it, we only used it once. And that was the day we learned it. But unfortunately, we will have to use it. What do you mean? If you say merge us all, but what do you say? Do you know what that would mean? And do you know I don't know? But it's the only option to not die. That mortal is too powerful. We have to do it. At that moment, Vermouth would tell this to the others, who would instantly doubt, but they realized that they had to accept if or if, so they finally accepted it. All this, the gods told them in their minds, in just a few milliseconds. Goku's power was about to impact with Vermouth, which was planned to disappear him from existence. But this would change completely when suddenly, a strong light would be seen in the place, which would leave totally surprised Goku. But what happened? What is it? The light was getting stronger and stronger, and Goku did not understand absolutely nothing of what was happening. The whole place was being attracted by this immense light emitted by a very powerful being. The universes and planets were being affected by this great power, because this force affected even reality itself. Well, at the moment, 11 powerful beings had decided to merge into one being. All this using as main the essence of the god of destruction, Beerus. A being had appeared in front of Goku, and would destroy, in front of him, the technique that he had used against them. What the hell did you just do? How did you get rid of that technique so easily? Who are you? I'm the reincarnation of your own sin. That's right. It's just what you're thinking, Saiyan. We didn't want to use this technique, but we were forced to use it. No way we'd allow you to kill us like that. Don't you understand? It's too humiliating for us all that a Saiyan could have done this to us. But now with all our powers, conforming to one being, things will be totally different, mortal. This technique is the only one we all learned from, that we thought we would never have to use. But still, a mortal came along, and surpassed all the gods, and that's totally unacceptable. Ah, I see. Very interesting. I hope this way, if you can amuse me even a little bit. If not, I'd be completely disappointed in the gods of destruction. Since you received my technique, now it's your turn. What are you saying? I'll give you a chance. Throw me your most powerful technique, and I'll receive it in full. I promise I won't dodge it. Huh, what is this Saiyan thinking? But what an idiot. I really can't believe that he'd provoke his own death. I thought he had really stopped being so stupid. But I see that he still is. What an idiot. That attack will end his life instantly. Saiyan, it was nice to meet you, but it's time for you to die. The fusion would do their most powerful technique, which was called Soul Terminator. They would do this technique to Goku, saying to him, "Die, Domino." At that moment, the power would impact with Goku, and this would provoke a great explosion, which had universal magnitudes. What made thousands of nearby planets were completely destroyed, even getting to draw the attention of even Zeno-sama himself. But meanwhile, that power seemed to have had an effect, because the power of Goku was not felt anywhere. This would make everyone believe that Goku had died. Really, that bastard was an idiot. All the times I thought of killing him, I never thought it would get to this point. But how unfortunate was that? In that, from the debris caused by the explosion, Goku would come out with some wounds. And he would say, "I gave you the opportunity, and you didn't know how to take advantage of it. And that means now it's my turn, and I'll finish them." At that moment, Goku, in his state of Ultra Instinct dominated, would quickly throw himself toward the fusion, giving him a strong blow in the stomach that would make him draw blood. Ah, but he's still powerful, that Saiyan. The blow he gave me almost left me without breathing. Said this, the fusion in the same way would attack Goku, and then would hit him several times, making Goku a little surprised to see that they were facing him. After a few moments, Goku was being overshadowed by the power of the fusion. These were hitting Goku, and they didn't stop at any time. Saiyan, well, what happened now? It's not so funny anymore, is it? But minutes later, well, that's enough. It's time to show all my power. What? What do you mean, all your power? Wait, do you have any more? That's right. I had enough. I'll finish you in an instant. At that moment, Goku, from one second to the next, would pass to his most powerful state, which would leave the fusion as a big garbage. Yes, now know my true power! Meanwhile, on the other side, Zeno-sama had felt a great power, and he did not know what was happening in the universes, so he would go to the place where the power was. Goku's power was extremely gigantic. It was something that even left Daishin Khan speechless, who had felt it from where he was. But what is all this power? Where does it come from? But Zeno-sama went to see him, and did not allow me to accompany him. I fear for the life of the king and everything. Possibly this was not just any opponent. Something tells me that things are totally different now. This is someone we should be worried about. I haven't felt all that power since I was with the god Azarama. I must go. I can't leave Zeno-sama alone. It would be a huge risk. I must protect him even though he warned me not to. I don't care about the risks. I must know that he is well. On the other hand, Goku, who had shown all this power, would say to the fusion, I warn you, this is the peak of my power. If I were you, I would not attack. I would rather die a clean death than suffer the consequences of my mistake. The fusion had been speechless to see that Goku had shown all his power, since they saw him in something different. However, this fusion didn't even imagine what it would be for this Saiyan. So this one would say, think about it, mortal. Do you really think that I would be scared just because you say so? Please, Saiyan, don't be an idiot. I noticed something different in you, but anyway, you're still a Saiyan. After killing you, we will remember you forever, because you have made us all have to resort to that nasty fusion to defeat you. It's a humiliation we will have to endure, but I know that you will be the first and the last. Besides that, you will go straight to hell for daring to face us. Damn you. I see, so you will not heed my warning, then you will die in the worst possible way. Are you really thinking of killing me with that insignificant power? Now I see who's the stupid one. You should be begging me not to kill you, but your pride won't let you. I know that inside you, you won't be able to do absolutely nothing against me. I already gave you the moment you wanted so much. I let you beat me enough. Now it's my moment. It's better that you live with that trauma, but I will be kind, and I will kill you to avoid that humiliation. So that's what you say. Shut up and disappear. The fusion would do a technique to Goku which was known as the Hakai, but this technique would not do any effect to Goku, leaving him somewhat confused, because he did not understand what had been done to him. If absolutely nothing had happened to him. What did you do? I didn't feel anything. But how pathetic you are. How? What happened? My technique didn't do anything to him. It's the first time it has no effect on a mortal, but what happened? I told you, idiot, it's not necessary that you try to look for some mistake in your technique. You know perfectly well what happens, and you just checked it. Only your mind doesn't want to accept it. You're completely stupid. You can't do anything against me. The fusion, even though deep down they knew it, they didn't accept it in any way. Damn Saiyan, what are you thinking? This one would throw himself against the Saiyan, and would give him millions of hits in a few seconds, which Goku would dodge without any difficulty. You're too slow. Take this! Goku with a finger would hit the fusion, which would send him far away from the place, and would make him crash against several rocks. But how? How? Not again! Damn it! He overpowered us even though we were fused together. I have to admit, we can't fight him. That bastard somehow got too strong. This is what the fusion was thinking at that time. Goku, a little angry, would say, what are you going to do now? Tell me your last words before you die. I must also be surprised, because you made me release all my power. I didn't think that someone like you could do it. I must feel humiliated. I don't know. But well, now, if you've thought about your last words. The fusion knew that it could do absolutely nothing, and this one didn't know what to do at that moment. What the hell do we do? It's far superior to us fused. I have no other choice but to continue attacking until the end. I will not surrender to that idiot. Goku would see that this one didn't answer him anything. So he would say, okay, I see you want to die without saying anything. It seems to me something sincere not to give a word. Goku would do a technique which would make the opponent suffer a lot, before this one finishes with his life. For the last time, you want to say something? Unexpectedly for Goku, the fusion would launch itself to attack him again, and this would leave something surprised and angry to Goku, and this would say to him, damn! Insolent! How dare you! Now take this! Goku in that moment, furious, would launch his technique to the fusion, but just before launching it, Goku would feel something behind him very strange, which would make him undo the technique and turn around quickly. Because the guy he had behind his back was the king of everything, Zeno-sama. Goku would see this one and would be somewhat surprised, but the fusion would say, "Oh, great Senno-sama, what is he doing here?" "So you're the ones that caused all this, Gods of Destruction, because you merged? Can't Senno-sama see that?" "Oh, hello Goku, how are you? What are you doing here?" "Oh, but what a surprise. You've come, Senno-sama. I did not expect it. Goku, what are you doing in this place?" "Senno-sama, I don't know, but I have something to tell you, and it's the reason why I'm here now. Tell me, Goku, what happened? And now that I realize, why didn't you visit me?" "It's about what I'm going to tell you, Senno-sama. A few years ago, I went to train innocently in the Time Chamber, and in that place, they locked me up for years. I think it was partly because you and I were very close friends." But what the heck? Why did you, in the name of gods, you know that you were forbidden to mess with that Saiyan. Why did you do it? I'll punish you all." "Senno-sama, that is no longer necessary. I'm more than enough to do it." "Oh, you say you've become stronger?" "That's right. And that's why I'll kill those idiots." "No, what are you saying? You can't kill them. They're the only ones capable of their job. By punishment, I don't mean killing Saiyan." "I'm sorry, Senno-sama, but that's the only way to end this." "No problem. Goku, even though we're friends, I will not allow you to end their lives. That's only for me to decide. They cannot be replaced easily. That's why I have resisted and not killed them on several occasions. I'm the only one who decides. That's not your job, Goku."
"So I see, Senno-sama. You don't understand either. From what you say, I guess you'll kill me if I try. It goes without saying, but you're right. Our friendship is not as important as the welfare of the universes. Those that I have eliminated have not been simply because of anger. They have been because the gods and angels have been against me, and I had to eliminate those universes."
"Then I have no other choice but to face you. You nor anyone else will avoid the death of these damned ones. They locked me up and they'll pay for it. That's why I have to kill them."
"Goku, I warn you, if you try to disobey me, I will disappear you instantly. You better not try it, Saiyan."
"Then if you oppose all this, I will have to kill you, Senno-sama."
After Senno-sama's opposition, Goku would tell him that he would have to kill him. This would surprise Senno-sama because he never believed that Goku would dare to challenge him in such an errant way. Senno-sama would tell Goku, saying, "You're realizing what you're saying, and above all, to whom you're saying it."
"I thought you wouldn't get in the way of this, Senno-sama. I had no plans at any time to confront you. But the circumstances have arrived, and I will have to do it."
"Too bad for you, you will die to protect those insignificant gods. Things are not always the way you want, Senno-sama. You don't have the right after all you have done. You behave as if you were a child, and now you want me to believe you're different. In spite of your millions of years of existence, you never knew how to manage the universe as well. It seems that this role was too big for you. Any guy in the universe would do a better job than you."
Senno-sama was speechless when he heard what Goku had said to him. No one had ever been so direct with him, and it was logical because of the fear. One of Senno-sama's guardians would say to Goku,
"What did you say?
How dare you disrespect the king of everything, Senno-sama?" Senno-sama was very angry. They had hit him hard in his pride, and he would say, "Damn, how are you able to face me in the first place? Unfortunately, you're no longer the Goku of before which I knew. Now, I do not fail to say that things are very different now. So much time in that place, in the end, if I end up influencing your personality too much, you're no longer useful to me now. Then I will have no problem ending your life."
"Enough, Senno-sama. I'll make you disappear once and for all."
Senno-sama, upon hearing this, I would say, "The damage is irreparable. It is too late to repent, Saiyan." Senno-sama, after saying these words in a very serious tone, this one would say, "Disappear." And this one would do the technique which he used to eliminate the universes, but this time on Goku. It was enough that Senno-sama squeezed his hands to disappear anything he wanted, but this time he would do it at Goku, causing this one to disappear. Or this is what Senno-sama had thought.
"I told you that bastard shouldn't have challenged me at any time. He died for being stupid. The gods who had seen what had happened would thank him for having killed him, since they would have died if he had not done it."
Senno-sama would no longer punish them, seeing that they did it for justified reasons, and realizing that Goku deserved to die. Although really, if they should be punished, because these had caused all this in the personality of Goku, for having locked him in that place. These would tell Senno-sama that they could not unmerge, but Senno-sama would do a technique to undo the fusion. However, before doing so, something had pierced the fusion, and this would make him draw blood. Senno-sama would look quickly and would realize that Goku was still alive despite his technique, the fusion would quickly fall to the ground and would say,
How is he alive? Zeno-sama eliminated him in front of me. I can't take it anymore.
The fusion would bleed out on the spot, and after a few moments it would disappear completely, due to the destructive energy of the Saiyan. Zeno-sama would be stunned.
What the hell? You killed them! How come you're still alive? Damn it!
You should have disappeared, you bastard! Zeno-sama, even I am on a totally different level than you are. I'm more powerful, and that's why your technique didn't even tickle me. You've had your turn. Now it's mine.
Shut up, idiot! Guardians, attack!
At that moment, the Guardians of Zeno-sama would throw themselves against Goku, and these would move in a very coordinated and precise way. Such movements surprised Goku a little, but even though they were strong and fast, they couldn't do anything to the Saiyan. So this one with a single blow would send them away, making them crash against several rocks. Zeno-sama, I told you that you had your turn. Now it's time for you to die. Goku was about to confront Zeno-sama, but suddenly Daishin Kan would appear on the scene. Zeno-sama would see this and tell him, "What are you doing here, Daishin Kan? I ordered you not to do this." Zeno-sama, I have come because I know that his life is in danger. That mortal is no longer the weak that he was before. Somehow he increased his power beastly, and now he is too powerful. Daishin Kan, I order you to leave. I will not repeat it again. Get out of this place. I can only fight this idiot. Daishin Kan would refuse this, and Goku would say to him, "So you also want to face me, you Daishin Kan. I hope you know that I eliminated one of your sons to protect a god of destruction. And if you face me, you'll suffer the same fate as him." Zeno-sama would threaten Daishin Kan again with eliminating him if he did not leave this place. But again, he would not listen. And Goku would tell him not to let him leave, because he would also face him. "I'll fight you first, Daishin Kan. Finally, someone who can entertain me a little bit. The others were too weak and bored me." "I see, Goku. We will fight. I never thought that a moment like this would come, although I imagined a little that someone like you could go too far. It's strange that someone like me will face a being that only exists for decades." "As you say, Daishin Kan, I don't care. I'll kill you, and then I'll do it with Zeno-sama." Both would start fighting after saying this, and Daishin Kan was asking him to face Goku. And both would fight, and this would be felt even by the Sekrin multiverse. What would cause impact in all those who could feel that power? Reality itself was being altered by all this power. It was something never seen before. Daishin Kan, for the first time, was fighting in a series, and now he was seeing all his power to the maximum. Daishin Kan would do a technique to immobilize Goku, that no matter how much Goku wanted to, he could not be able to move. Daishin Kan would hit Goku again and again, taking advantage that he could not get rid of his technique. Goku did not know what was happening to him. Daishin Kan was causing him many problems without much effort. Goku was having received several hits from Daishin Kan. He finally managed to get out of Daishin Kan's technique, and he managed to hit Daishin Kan with a strong blow that would make him crash against several rocks. But this time, things were being different for Goku, because Daishin Kan was somewhat superior to him. Daishin Kan was moving so fast that Goku was not able to perceive his movements. Goku was shocked, because he didn't believe he had so much power. "I see, Daishin Kan. In the end, you were stronger than me. Can't believe I had to resort to this. I'll have to use my last transformation."
"How? New transformation?"
Goku at this point would start to raise his power. At that moment, the Saiyan would be seen to give off a great light, and his increased power would be felt by the universes, leaving everyone who felt it with a face of absolute fear. They only had to pray that it was not an evil being. Daishin Kan would see this and would say, "But what happens? Do you think that with a simple increase of power it will be enough to win me? Do you really believe that?" Immediately from this dust would come a being with a totally different appearance, which would leave Daishin Kan speechless.
"Daishin Kan, as I told you, I never thought I'd have to use this transformation against any opponent, but I congratulate you. You were the first one to achieve it. However, you would have wished you didn't have to know it. This is my perfect state. It took me hundreds of years to learn to master it. It is a state far beyond the Ultra Instinct."
"But what do you say? What do you mean? Superior to the Ultra Instinct?"
"Let me explain. This state is beyond the divine comprehension. It perfects all the states, transformations, and techniques. The Ultra Instinct is nothing more than the root, the beginning of this power. However, this is totally different. Even though it is the root, unlike the other opponents, every action he takes, you will know it even before he thinks about it.
a state that has a force of destruction only compared to the Zamara being, a being that apparently hasn't appeared in millions of years. That's right. Inside that place, inside the time chamber, I also learned everything about the multiverse, its history, and everything that makes it up, thanks to Kaio-sama.
It's not possible! How is it that a mortal could reach that point? Even I tried to reach that state, but it was totally impossible. So I surrendered, and never chose to try to learn it again. How is it that you could overcome even the divine deities? Even few have perfected the Ultra Instinct, but I never thought that anyone could reach the perfected state. And even more so being immortal, it was definitely known that it was Zarama who possessed it.
But even so, Daishinkan could not allow this Saiyan to get away with it, because he had challenged Zeno-sama, and also had broken several rules in the universe. So he would tell him, "Son Goku, I don't care that you have assessed this state. I will not allow you to continue breaking the rules." Daishinkan at full speed would launch himself against the Saiyan. But Goku anticipated every move of Daishinkan. Although they were made instantly, Goku in the blink of an eye would make Daishinkan fall to the ground without being able to move.
"I told you, Daishinkan, why are you trying? If you know you can't do anything,
accept it. A mortal surpassed you. In fact, you never worried that there was someone superior to you, because you never imagined it. You only saw someone as simple as weak mortals. But now things turned out to be a little different. Now for protecting Zeno-sama, you will go with him. Of course, I will forgive you if you never bother me again." Zeno-sama would see this and say,
"No way, Saiyan. You killed the gods in front of me. When I told you it was totally forbidden for you to do so, you disobeyed my rules, and I won't forgive you for that."
"Daishinkan, stop it. Don't go on. You'll only make me kill you faster. If I have to solve it myself, don't get involved in this, Daishinkan. Go away." "And what are you supposed to do now, Zeno-sama? Do you think you have enough power to finish me off?"
"Don't worry, Goku. It's much more than that."
At that moment, Zeno-sama would approach where his guardians were, and at that moment, a great light and spacecraft was formed in the place. Zeno-sama had merged with his guardians. Zeno would see this and would be stunned at this.
"But what the hell? Did you just merge?"
"That's right. And with this new power, I will defeat you."
Interesting. I see that your body has changed. This way, it'll be more entertaining for me."
"Are you laughing? Wait till you see my power."
"Zeno-sama, I must tell you that no matter what you do, I am superior. And you can't do anything against that, dammit. Funny, everyone's afraid of you, but I never was. In the end, the fearful ones are the ones that never advance and stay stuck at one point. That's why they shouldn't exist. Fear is a disease, and it's even the most dangerous of all. It only serves to compress our true capabilities. Anyway, I understand a little bit the fear towards you, because you destroy planets and universes for stupid reasons. But it's over. You opposed my actions, and that's why you will die. I gave you a chance, and you wasted it. What an idiot you were. Goku, you should have been more careful with your words. And even more so when the one you say it to is me, the king of everything, Zeno-sama.
I don't care what you say. You will die."
Zeno-sama would throw himself against Goku, which would make him retreat. Zeno-sama would give thousands of blows to Goku, but against all odds, Goku prevented every move without much effort. Zeno-sama decided to increase all his power and show all his strength to Goku, because now both would be at their maximum.
"I see, Zeno-sama. Your power increased a lot, but I keep telling you that you're stupid. Do not keep trying. You know you will die."
Zeno-sama, without saying anything, would appear from behind Goku's back while he was unsuspecting, and would give a strong blow to the Saiyan that would send him far away from the place, making him crash against several rocks at the place. Goku, who was lying on the ground, would get up and say,
"You played dirty, and for that, you'll pay, idiot."
Goku, in an instant, would throw himself against Zeno-sama, hitting him with a huge amount of blows. Both were fighting, but something terrifying was happening because of this. Daishinkan, who was watching the fight, would realize this and say to Zeno-sama,
"King of everything, you must stop this now as fast as possible. Otherwise, he will destroy the universes." "Wait, what do you mean, Daishinkan? You mean destroy universes?"
"Zeno-sama, it's worse than I thought. Do you remember the four supreme demons?"
"That's right, Daishinkan, but what's wrong with that? I don't understand."
"You see, because of your fight with that Saiyan, you're causing abysmal disorders in the universes. And the portal that we closed millions of years ago is opening again. And if we let that portal open completely, those four supreme demons will come out.
which only Zarama could defeat millennia ago. If they appear now, it would be impossible to finish them. Zeno-sama must finish the fight quickly. Goku would hear this and say to Daishin Khan,
"Wait, you say four supreme demons? I'm intrigued to know how powerful are those such demons. It seems something very interesting. But anyway, I cannot allow them to leave that place."
At that moment, Zeno-sama and Daishin Khan would try to close the portal before it opens again, but it was impossible.
Goku and Zeno-sama had been having an abysmal fight, which caused even reality itself to be altered. So much power exposed, causing things that in millions of years never thought it would happen. All the gods and angels in ancient times were told about the story of four demons who had appeared millions of years ago and had made disasters in all the universes. They were unstoppable. No one, not even Zeno-sama, could stop them. They were extremely powerful. Until one day, the only person who had been able to do something against them was Zarama. He locked them up with the help of Daishin Khan and Zeno-sama, and so they remained locked up for millions and millions of years, until, because of this battle, the portal had begun to open again. At this time, Zeno-sama and Daishin Khan tried to prevent this from happening. Even Goku himself would have tried to prevent this portal from opening, but it was totally useless. The desire of those four demons to leave was much stronger than the power of any being at that moment.
"But what is happening, Daishin Khan? We could not close it."
Apparently, the dimension could no longer contain all that power. It took the slightest contact with that place, and that all that was expelled.
"I see, Zeno-sama. That's why we couldn't close it."
At that moment, the four supreme demons would come out of that place and immediately appear in front of Goku and the others.
"Damn, Goku! You see what you've caused by your stupidity? Only by your useless whim. Now you'll take care of this damn problem."
"What are you talking about, you bastard? If you hadn't opposed me, this never would have happened."
"Shut up, you damn Saiyan. You just put the existence of the universe at risk. Now you'll take care of it."
At that moment, Daishin Khan and Zeno-sama would quickly leave the place, knowing that they could do absolutely nothing against those demons, leaving thus everything for the Saiyan, Goku. While this was happening, in another place, Vegeta was training with the Yardratans, because he wanted to take revenge on Goku for the humiliation he had given him some time ago. On that planet, the Yardratans created at the request of Vegeta a prototype equal to the time chamber that was on Earth, and Vegeta was training in that place, and surprisingly, even though he was in another dimension, he could feel that abysmal power.
"But what is that power? Where does it come from? Is it Kakarot? No, it can't be him. I feel four guys with an overwhelming power. What the heck is going on out there?"
Meanwhile, in the palace of Zeno-sama, Goku was in front of those four demons, and one of them said to him,
"Hey you, tell us who you are. Are you a friend of that insignificant dwarf of Zeno-sama? What are you doing in this place?"
Goku, angered by these words, would reply, "I'm not friends with anyone, least of all with that damn Zeno-sama. I know who you are, and I know what you've done in the past.
But we don't know you. How do you know it, mortal?"
As I would not know if the same Bills had told me about you. I never believed him, but I see he wasn't lying.
And what are you supposed to do now, mortal?
You will be the first victim. I can't wait to kill you. So much time locked up in that place has made me want to do it like I never did before.
That's right, Kimura, let's kill this idiot. And then we'll go for that dwarf Zeno-sama and that stupid Daishin Khan priest.
But wait, they say they'll kill me.
I don't think so. But this will be very interesting.
Hey, Kimura, take care of that guy. He already started to bother me.
Whatever you say, Zumi.
I see. So you'll be the first one to face me. This time I won't be confident. I must be very careful of these guys. They have devastating techniques, and if I don't stop them in time, I'll end up losing.
Attack, mortal. I will let you strike first. I swear I will not protect myself in any way.
But how stupid you are. You'll regret this.
Well, fine. As you say.
At that moment, Goku, with all his power, would throw himself against the demon and would give him millions of blows in just a few seconds. Each blow made by Goku was extremely powerful, and this would make that in a few seconds, the body of this demon would be completely finished.
But what an idiot. You said I would regret this. How strange. I didn't think it would be so easy to do this. What a damn disappointment.
Goku, seeing that these demons were not what he thought, he would retreat from the place. But however, at that moment, he would receive a strong kick in the back, which was made by this same demon. Goku would fall to the ground after this great blow and would turn around, realizing that the Kumure demon was in perfect condition and that his wounds had disappeared completely. This does not end here, Saiyan. Now it's my turn. The Kumure demon would throw himself against Goku, but Goku again had given him millions of hits more. Goku would make sure to leave him again in a deplorable state. But every time Goku did it, this demon would appear as if nothing in just a few seconds. Goku's worst fear was starting to show, because the demon was really only stealing Goku's power. Every time he hit him, Goku tried to avoid any kind of technique, and the only thing he did was fall for a simple trick. Mortal, I think I've stolen enough power to kill you. I love to kill my opponents with their own power. It's so much fun.
But what are you saying? What's going on?
Suddenly, Goku had stopped being in his perfect state and had returned to his previous state.
But what the hell? What happened? What did you do to me, you stupid bastard? Why did my power diminish so much?
Listen well, Saiyan. Because of your stupidity, with each blow that you had given me, you've given me small amounts of your power. Each time that one of your fists touched my body, this would not have happened more if you had not given me millions of blows. In the end, those small amounts of stolen energy became something giant. That happens when you fail to understand your enemy. He deceives you very easily, making you believe that it's too easy. But he rarely goes beyond that.
But what are you saying, damn you? You're a damn rat! You shouldn't have left that filthy place. I don't care what you say. I won't let you beat me that way. Die!
Goku was still with a huge rage for what had been done to him, and this stupidity, he would continue beating the demon, so it would go down in power more and more.
But what a waste! This mortal has too much power, and he was not able to know how to use it. What a disappointment. I guess it's time to kill him.
Damn demon, you stole all my power! I swear you'll pay for it!
The demon Zumi at that moment, from behind, would give Goku a blow in the head that would leave him unconscious.
Well, Kimura, kill him already!
At that moment, this demon would be about to kill him, but suddenly one of the other demons would appear and would say,
"Wait! Don't kill him. Don't be an idiot."
This demon would be surprised by the words of the other guy and would answer him.
"Ah, but what are you saying? You just said not to kill this mortal. But what the hell are you talking about? Why wouldn't I kill this mortal if he clearly had all the intentions of killing me? Are you listening to yourself?"
"Listen, it's not like that. You don't see. If you kill him, you'd be wasting someone with impressive powers, even superior to you. Well, before you stole part of his power."
"And why would I leave alive someone that could have been more powerful than me?"
"Believe it or not, he can be of great use to us. We'll make him join us. It's that easy. If he doesn't, we'll kill him. In that state, he can't do anything to us. We'll just wait for him to wake up after that blow Zumi gave him."
"It's okay. I won't kill him because you're right. Maybe the Supreme Demon King will thank me a lot."
"What the hell is wrong with you? You can't talk about him in this multiverse. Someone might be listening. Remember that he told us only Zeno-sama knew about all that."
"I hadn't thought about it. I didn't know what happened to me. Well, it's time to go. We'll take that mortal with us."
After this, some time would pass, and Goku had woken up in an unknown place for him. The key he perceived in that place felt totally different to what he was used to.
"But what is this place? How strange. The last thing I remember is that one of those damn demons hit me in the head."
Goku would think this, but instantly the demons realized that he had woken up, and they would stand in front of him.
"Saiyan, I know you don't understand what you're doing in this place, but before you say anything, we could have killed you at that instant. But nevertheless, we decided not to end your life."
"And why didn't you kill me? Are you stupid?"
"They made a big mistake."
Goku, without hardly saying anything, had launched himself to attack one of the demons, but Zumi would stop him by grabbing his arm and would tell him strongly,
"Stop! You can't do anything!"
"What happened to the other part of my power? I thought I'd get it back! What happened to me?"
"Well, I'm afraid, Saiyan, that you lost it. But there's only one way to get it back. The power that Kimura stole from you, you can't get it back unless he gives it back to you. And for now, I think he has no plans to do that."
"What bastards! They steal my power and now they plan to threaten me."
"Saiyan, you will not be able to continue with that arrogance. We already have something planned for you, and that is you can join us. Be a part of the Supreme Demonic Elite. You'd be of great help to us, and you'd be a fundamental part of it."
"And if I say no, then what will happen? They will let me go as if nothing?"
"It's obvious that no. I think I already know what your point is. They'll kill me if I don't accept it."
"Well, that's fine. I'll have to join their stupid elite."
"That's the way I like it. You were very smart to accept. but I want you to be respectful towards us, because now you'll be part of it.
But tell me, where are we?
Well, Zumi, you better explain to this Saiyan.
Listen, mortal, right now you're in another universe, specifically that of the demons.
What are you saying? Another multiverse? But isn't there only supposed to be one?
Well, that's what everyone thinks in your multiverse, except Zeno-sama, who had never told anyone about it, not even Daishinkan, who's been with him for millions and millions of years. He never wanted the truth to be known. The Supreme Demon King told us a long time ago, and did not confide in you, because only me and the other Supreme Demons know it.
And why would you tell me? Someone like me, what sense would it make?
You have to know everything to know why you are here. You're the only being from another multiverse that has come to enter this one. Well, things happened like this. Billions and billions of years ago, the Creator God had two sons, whom he named Zarama and Shimuko. One was a demon and the other was different. At that time, there were 38 universes. This other demon was jealous with his brother, and both fought many years for the power of the universes, until one day his father got tired of this and decided to divide it in two, and Zarama would stay with 12 universes like his brother. So they were named multiverses. His father had put a barrier between the universes, which made it impossible for someone from one multiverse to pass to another. And so time passed. The Creator God decided to cease to exist because he had already completed his work and was not thinking of doing anything more. So this would disappear, which caused that barrier was destroyed. And the Supreme Demon King sent us to attack this multiverse. But Zarama, with the help of Zeno-sama, locked us in a dimension. Later, Zarama managed to rebuild that barrier, and since then, he's never awakened. That's how two multiverses exist.
Goku would be speechless when he heard all this, because he had no idea about that. Now I understand. And what do they plan to do? How do we enter this multiverse if there was supposed to be a barrier?
It was the portal that created the Supreme Demon King. In fact, we must go to where he is to inform him of a new ally. I hope he thanks me.
Do not make flowers to you. We were all idiots. At this moment, these would go to where the Supreme King of everything was to tell him. But really, Goku was thinking, as soon as I get my powers back, I'll kill these fuckers for ruining all my plans. And for stealing my power. Meanwhile, I'll have to pretend to be their ally. What a bummer.
They would arrive at the Supreme Demon King, and all of them would prostrate themselves before him. Except for Goku, who didn't seem to be afraid of this being, even though he knew who he was. The demons would be surprised to see that the Saiyan did not prostrate before the Supreme Demon King.
Saiyan, prostrate yourself. Don't you know who you have in front of you? Of course I know. You told me many times.
The Demon King would be surprised because he had not seen the demons for many millions of years, and now they appeared with a new subject.
What a surprise, but they finally arrived. Tell me, who is this guy that you bring with you?
He's a mortal that we found in the other universe. After we were able to free ourselves from the confinement that Zarama made us many years ago, we believe that he had a fight with Zeno-sama. Understand that we are talking about a mortal who faced the king of all that universe. Well, the thing is that Kimura again used the technique where he steals the powers of his enemies, and if he hadn't done it, maybe that Saiyan could have defeated him. Finally, we convinced him to join us. He wants to tell him his plans.
What is wrong with you? I didn't give you permission at any time to bring someone from another universe. But now I'll have to accept it. And one of you will have to pay for doing so.
Forgive the imprudence, King, but better tell him what your plan is.
Well, listen, Saiyan. With your help, we can take the power of that multiverse that so many millennia and millennii have wanted. You will have to go with them to take each universe. And finally, all of them are yours. If Zeno-sama and Daishinkan are still alive, you must kill them. Unless, of course, they join us, which will never happen. Finally, I will have to face my brother, Zarama. But he is sleeping right now, and I don't think he'll wake up for a few millennia more.
Meanwhile, Zeno-sama and Daishinkan have stopped feeling Goku's ki, so they thought that those demons had killed him. But they knew that it had not been so because there were no demons in any of the universes. So Daishinkan decided to ask the dragon Zarama where Goku was. But this would answer that unfortunately he could not reveal its location, because it revealed information that his creator Zarama had ordered never to say. This left Daishinkan very intrigued, who could not explain where Goku could be. Zeno-sama had returned to his palace, but suddenly Goku would appear and tell them,
"Damned, I will finish the work I started."
Goku would appear and tell them, "Damned, I will finish the work I started."
In the universe of the demons, some time had passed since the Demon King had spoken with Goku. Goku had to become stronger, so he would tell the other Supreme Demons that somehow he had to train. In this universe, the time passed completely different, so Goku would not have used any kind of different place to train. Goku somehow had to recover his powers, but even though he tried to get them in different ways, he could not. And at that moment, Goku thought, "I see, I'll never get the power I once had. Those darn demons took it away from me. But thanks to that, I'll become even stronger than I was before. I see that this place is totally different, and my training will be much more effective here. I will learn the base techniques of the demons, and while I pretend to be one of them, they will wish they had never trusted me. If they thought that stealing my powers would serve to ensure their safety, well, they're not right. I'll make them trust me so much that it won't even cross their minds that I'll betray them." At that moment, Goku would leave the place he was, because he had to learn to live with all the demons of that universe and be part of them. The Supreme Demons would tell the ordinary demons that the guy Goku was one of them, so no one had problems with this Saiyan. Goku would get to one of the demon universes, and there he would meet a guy who immediately knew that this Saiyan did not come from his universe, nor from any other. This guy noticed in Goku everything that he wanted to hide. So someone would approach Goku and tell him that he knew everything, that he was not part of them. Goku would be surprised because no other demon had ever realized that. For some reason, this demon seemed to know everything. Goku would say to him, surprised, "Ah, how come you know that? Who the heck told you?" "Hey, listen, if you say a single word, I'll kill you, asshole. I'm not in the mood for stupid games. Tell me, do you want to die?" Goku would say this with a very serious expression and would take the guy's hand. But he did not come with the intentions that Goku thought. And he would say, "Hey, calm down. I didn't come to harm you. I only wanted to help you. I know absolutely everything. You came to this multiverse forced by those Supreme Demons, and now you pretend to be part of them because you really have no other option. You thought about getting stronger to revolt against them, but it won't be as easy as you think."
"Wait, you really know all that? But how is it possible?
I don't even know you."
"It's just a unique technique I have, to know the past of any person. I never used to care, but I saw you were different. I just want to help you. I'm the only person that can help you defeat those Supreme Demons, and especially the Demon King. I have a lot to teach you. In fact, in some point in my life, I was his master. But he became stronger, and then he treated me like garbage, and just left me wandering as the simple demon in these universes, while he rules all the multiverse. That's why I want to help you kill him. And then you could take his place. No one will find out that you're not a demon."
Goku and this demon would have a training, in which Goku would learn many new techniques, and his power had increased immeasurably, but he still did not recover the power he had before. But little by little, he recovered more power. Goku would think, "That demon can have my power, but he cannot take full advantage of it because he's not a Saiyan. My strength and power can only be used by me. But well, at some point, that idiot will realize it was absolutely of no use to him." Goku would continue training with this demon, who would now become his master. Goku would learn forbidden techniques that only the Demon King knew. Goku, in a short time, would have recovered all of his power. And at that moment, Goku had been called by the Demon King, because he would send him to finish his work, and to eliminate Daishin Khan and Zeno-sama. Goku would go to his multiverse again through a portal, and what was shown before would happen.
How did you not die? I knew it. Those demons didn't kill you. And where are they? Didn't they come with you?
It's not necessary for them to come with me. I started this, and now I'll finish it. I hope that the time that I was not there, at least you've reflected a little. And you, Zeno-sama, I would say it, running away from the enemy. You left me alone against those demons. What a damned coward. That is why you both will die, and I'll enjoy it too much.
But where were you, damn Saiyan? I didn't feel you anywhere. I can't explain it.
At that moment, Daishin Khan was totally confused, because he didn't understand how he stopped feeling the power of Goku in all the corners of the multiverse. The only one who had understood everything was Zeno-sama, because he was the only one who knew everything.
I see, Goku. So they tried it with you. They convinced you, right?
Those idiots tried it with me in the past, and I didn't accept it. That's why the first and second multiverse war happened.
In fact, I'd forgotten about you guys completely, but that stupid Demon King sent me to finish the job, and I must comply. Then in the future, he plans to return to face his brother Zarama, but that guy he's talking about seems too powerful. I wouldn't want to wake him up. Anyway, right now I have to kill them. Zeno-sama would tell Goku,
"Well, try it, you damn Saiyan."
Goku at that moment would transform into his most powerful state, in which he had boosted his ancient strength in that state. Goku, without saying anything, in moments, would have already hit them both a few times, which would make them fall to the ground. But they would get up quickly and Zeno-sama would say,
"I see you're a little stronger than before, but I will not let you kill us."
Goku and Zeno-sama had started a short fight, in which the advantage of the Saiyan was too clear, and this would leave Zeno-sama on the ground.
"Well, this is quicker than I thought. What a bummer."
Goku would do one of his techniques to eliminate both of them, and he would throw it to kill them. But suddenly, someone would appear and destroy it. Goku would be stunned to see who had stopped and destroyed his technique.
"But what are you doing here? Didn't you die when Beerus and I finished with the Earth?"
"I escaped from that place, Kakarot. Did you think I'd die so easily? Don't be stupid. How do you think the great Vegeta would disappear like that?"
"I see. I should have made sure to kill you at that moment. Seriously, you came to this place. You could escape from me before. Now you've come to be killed by me."
"Vegeta, are you an idiot?"
"Well, you saved me the trouble of having to look for you at some point."
"Kakarot, I think you're wrong. If I came here, it was to kill you after the humiliation you gave me before. I couldn't stand it. It gave me too much anger. And I went to the planet of the Atreides and I trained in a time chamber similar to that of Earth. But this was much more improved. What you achieved in a millennium, I achieved in 200 years. If I've not died, it's because I also became immortal like you. And it's time for you to die, Kakarot."
"And what makes you think you'll kill me, Vegeta? Do you really want to die? I told you before, you just became my main target." "How lucky are these two? You came just to save them. How pitiful." "You tried me, Vegeta. You know that with that insignificant transformation, you won't even tickle me. I'll eliminate all three of you with a single attack. You were already too much of a nuisance for me."
"Well, I'm sorry to tell you, Kakarot, that you won't be able to. If you thought this was my real transformation, well, you're wrong. I told you, in all that time in the chamber, I reached an overwhelming power."
"I see, Vegeta. So you don't plan to give up. Then I'll finish you right away."
"That's not all. I haven't shown you my true power yet. You will see it right now."
At that moment, the whole place would begin to tremble. The nearest stars had exploded, and this great power would be felt by all the universes. Even the angels would feel it. As Marcerita, who would be frightened to feel this enormous power, Vegeta had reached his final form, which Goku had at that moment. At that moment, Goku's expression changed completely. He would be stunned to see that Vegeta had also reached that transformation.
"But how did you get it? It's impossible. I spent 1,000 years trying to get it. It can't be. Damn Vegeta. I really should have killed you on Earth. Anyway, it's too late."
"It's okay, Vegeta. We will both use all our powers. And I really hope you don't disappoint me, Vegeta."
"You're finished, Kakarot."
Goku would increase all his power, and then both would start an abysmal battle. Their movements were so fast that not even Daishinkan or Zeno-sama were able to perceive any movement. They were moving at an unimaginable speed.
"Surprising, Vegeta. You follow my pace. This is fascinating, but you're lacking."
"Don't be obnoxious, Kakarot. I have yet something to demonstrate."
Vegeta would increase his power to the maximum, and both would continue to have an indispensable battle. Vegeta would use one of his techniques that the Yardradians had taught him, and he would multiply by 3, leaving Goku a little confused. This technique was special, because even though 2 were an illusion, each hit that each one would made, it was as if Vegeta himself was doing it, but without any loss of power.
"What? How did he do it? I feel each of the blows which are connected with all of his power. What the heck is he doing?"
"I must know which one of them is him, and connect an accurate hit to the real one." Goku was receiving more and more hits, and he was not able to withstand it, as if 3 people with the same power were hitting him.
"What's the matter, Kakarot? You're cornered. You can't do anything."
These 3 would make a very powerful final flash, which would be thrown to Goku, and these would hit the Saiyan directly, filling the whole place with dust.
"Seriously, it was so easy to annihilate that trash. I don't believe it. That insect would die so easily."
From the smoke, Goku would come out and tell Vegeta,
"That's all? That's what you learned? Too bad those Yardradians didn't teach you the techniques they should have taught you. What a pity."
"I knew it. You wouldn't die with that technique. Well then, get this."
Vegeta would begin to make his most powerful attack at that moment, which he had created in the Room of Time.
This power disintegrated absolutely everything he touched, and Vegeta had named it Spiritual Destroyer. Vegeta would create this power, and then throw it at the Saiyan. Goku had no way to dodge it, so he would receive it fully. This would impact with Goku at that moment, but this time it would have been different, because he would have been hurt all over his body. I almost didn't survive. I trusted that technique too much. I would have died if I hadn't protected myself in time. But even so, it left me very injured. Fascinating, Vegeta. You managed to hurt me. But I regret to tell you that you are not strong enough to defeat me. I tested your strength and you've become very powerful. But you're not up to defeat me. From the beginning, I've noticed you're not even able to master that transformation. You didn't take the time to know it and try to master it. Maybe that was your mistake. But I'm sorry to tell you, they won't have another chance. It's time for you to die, Vegeta.
But what are you saying, Kakarot? Stop lying! You're not stronger than me!
Vegeta, angry at Goku's words, would throw himself against the Saiyan. But Goku would stop him without problems, and would tell him, "It's too late, Vegeta. You made a big mistake." Vegeta would lose his transformation at that moment, because he couldn't master it, and he would fall to the ground.
No, it can't be! Not again! I trained too much for this to happen! I'm a complete fool!
Vegeta, now it's time to annihilate them all. They were waiting too long, but finally the time has come. I'll do my most powerful technique. Goku would do one of his most powerful techniques, which was similar to the Hakai, but just before killing them, Goku had started to slowly disappear from that place. Goku would be surprised and think, "No way, my time in this place is up. I won't be able to eliminate them." Goku was about to disappear, but before he would say, "I swear I'll come back, and this time I won't make so many detours." Goku at that moment would appear in the universe of demons, and he was extremely angry for not being able to kill them on time. Those bastards were saved. I was about to eliminate them. They're too lucky. Next time I'll do it the right way. The Demon King would ask the Saiyan if he had completed his job, to which Goku would lie and tell them he had already taken care of it. "Well, I don't know what the King would do if he sees that you didn't fulfill his order. Saiyan, you've earned all my trust in recent times. That's why I want you to meet a person. She'll train you and make you become much stronger." Goku at that moment would think, "But how stupid. He's already trusting me, and that's excellent. Let him keep doing it, because later when I have enough power, I'll also kill him." The Demon King was wrong to underestimate the Saiyan, because at that moment he did not think that he could overcome him. So without any problem, he would introduce someone to Goku so that he could train him. At that moment, a woman would arrive saying, "Hello, father. So this is the man you want me to train. He seems to be someone interesting. It will be fun."
"Wait, she's your daughter. She'll be the one to train me. Are you sure this is the one?"
"Saiyan, are you doubting my daughter?"
"No, no, sir. It's not like that."
In that place, there was one of the Supreme Demons, and he would be surprised, because he would see that the King had already gained so much confidence in that Saiyan. This would bother him, and he would tell the Demon King,
"How is it possible that I trust this guy and now he puts him to train with the powerful Ning? The hell is wrong with him?"
"Remember that he's already part of us, so you must trust him. And besides, he will soon obtain the demon mark."
"Wait, what? What demon mark are you talking about?"
"Saiyan,
that's something I cannot tell you yet.
You will know soon. But first you must go train with my daughter." In another place, someone that everyone feared was about to wake up.
In the multiverse of the demons, a new being had awakened. All the power that was being felt in the entire multiverse because of the fight of the Saiyans made him wake up and free himself from the seal that his father had put on him thousands of years ago. The son of the Demon King had awakened, and he had been sealed because he had rebelled against those of his race. He did not agree with many of the things of his father, and it is because he had a heart full of evil, and he wanted things to be much worse. He had unleashed a war in all the universes, having lost many lives. But his father stopped him and decided to seal him forever. But now he woke up, and thanks to all of Goku's fights, this seal was breaking more and more, and reached the point where the gap that divided him from the rest was too weak. Meanwhile, Goku and Nin were in one of their training sessions. A few months had passed and Goku had become stronger. During all this time of training, the chemistry between them was becoming more and more noticeable, as he was beginning to realize that he was starting to like Nin, the daughter of the Demon King. And in the same way, the Supreme Nin was beginning to feel attraction towards the Saiyan. Goku could not believe in his mind that he was starting to like someone from the race that he hates so much, the Demon Race.
This thought was tormenting Goku, as he was trying to get Neen out of his head, but as much as he tried, it was intensifying more and more. Neen noticed that Goku was strange. She would ask him what was happening to him, because in the trainings he was starting to behave differently, and she did not understand him. Goku behaved in a cutting way, but this did not work. He realized that he really felt something for this demon, no matter how much it hurt. Time passed and both fell in love. The rumors that there was something between them spread throughout the universes, until they reached the ears of the Demon King. The other Supreme Demons were very angry to see that the Demon King did nothing to prevent this, and this was really what the Demon King wanted from the beginning. He knew this would happen. His plan was always to make them both fall in love and have a son, which would be someone with a totally unknown power, and would be very powerful. This was very beneficial to the king, so he allowed it without problems. But at that moment, the Demon King realized that a new power that he already knew had appeared again, after millennia. He would realize that it was his son, Kallus, and he would be surprised because he had been released from his Great Seal. The Demon King could perfectly defeat him again, but at that moment, he decided to test Goku. It was time to know if he was really worthy to be with his daughter, so he let his son do whatever he wanted, and let Goku take care of him. The Demon King thought, if this Saiyan is defeated by my son Kallus, he's not worthy of Neen, and I will kill him. Otherwise, he is more than perfect. What should I think? My son was released in a good moment. I will have to seal him again if the Saiyan does not manage to defeat him. Meanwhile, in another place, Goku and Neen were in their training, but suddenly a ball of energy would fall on that place, which made everything filled with smoke, surprising Goku and Neen.
But what happened? Who did it?
Moments later, the smoke dissipated, and Neen was speechless when she saw who it was. Goku did not understand who it was. He would ask Neen who that guy was, and why she was so surprised.
Goku, he's my brother. Kallus. My father locked him up, but somehow he's been released. How is it possible?
Neen, I will not allow it in any way.
What will you not allow, brother?
I will not allow you to be with this mortal. How dare you? He's not of your race. He's from another multiverse. You cannot be with him, sister. Why be with that mortal? Such weak beings are incapable of protecting themselves.
Goku would hear the words of this guy, and this would make him very angry, and he would say to the demon Kallus,
What did you say, you bastard? Are you underestimating me? You idiot!
Goku, what are you doing? Don't do it, please!
Neen, I must do it. This guy won't leave you alone. I see. So you want to fight. Well then say goodbye, because I won't have any mercy on you, Saiyan. Goku would increase his power, and would tell him, I hope you're ready, damn you. Goku, without saying anything else, would pass at an extreme speed, and he would scratch the body of this demon, causing him too to be surprised by the Saiyan's speed. Interesting. You're not an ordinary mortal. I see that you're somewhat powerful, but not powerful enough. The demon would also increase his power enormously. Both would have a battle in which the particles and atoms around them simply disappeared, as they were under the pressure of all that power. This fight was felt by the whole multiverse, and the Demon King would say, Finally, the moment has arrived. I was waiting for this moment with eagerness. I only hope they don't make too many disasters. Both were still fighting, but this demon would perform one of his techniques against Goku. This would become imperceptible to Goku's eyes, and this would hit Goku again and again. But however, Goku not only depends on sight only to fight, so he could know where his enemy was. Feeling the vibrations and waves of the place, the Saiyan would hit the demon hard, so he would crash against several planets.
Damn Saiyan, I see that you're strong. You knew how to counter my technique. Congratulations, you're the first to do it.
But this is just the beginning. Let me show you my true power. The Demon King Kallus would begin to increase all his power, making the universe tremble. He had released all his power, so this, in moments, would be launched to attack the Saiyan, and he would be winning.
Demon, you're very strong, but that does not mean you will win. I see with all your power, you're totally superior to me. The truth, I expected it. You're the son of the Demon King.
Goku, what are you doing? You already seen that he's superior to you. Don't keep going. My brother will kill you. We haven't had enough training yet for you to have mastered your powers.
I still don't care. I must kill this idiot at any cost. Kaioken times 10!
Goku with this power would appear in front of this demon, hitting him with strong blows, which would leave this demon confused. But he would say, If you use this technique, I will also use mine.
Supreme power, activate yourself!
Both had become serious and would give their full potential. The brother of Nin had shown his true power, and Goku was using his classic technique of Kaioken. This guy had shown all his power, so even with this technique, Goku was not able to beat him. The Demon King, who was watching the fight, he was very disappointed to see that Goku was being humiliated by his son. This in itself was already beginning to annoy the king, as he believed that the Saiyan would be strong enough. But he was really disappointed by this. One of the Supreme Demons who were watching him next to the king told him, "Sir, if you want, I could go and kill him myself for you, and I will also eliminate that Saiyan. I told you that he would never be able to defeat your son. You should have known that."
"Calm down. The fight's not over yet."
Meanwhile, in the place, the demon was humiliating the Saiyan. Even if he was using the Kaioken, it wasn't enough. The demon had been locked up for a long time, and had returned with an immeasurable power. Goku would tell him, "I knew you were someone strong when I saw you, but I didn't know you had all that damn power in you. Anyway, I swear I'll beat you even if you surpass me. No matter how strong an opponent is, the will that you have inside is what will make you beat him."
"I see, mortal. Now I want to see if you will carry on with your stupid will after that."
At that moment, the demon would grab Goku by the head and would drag him along the ground. At the same time, Goku would lose his transformation completely, and he would be lying on the ground in his base state. Goku was stunned, as this had not happened to him with any opponent in a very long time. Goku always seemed to have the advantage over others, but not this time. It wasn't the same. He met the wrong opponent at the wrong time. Nin would see the deplorable state Goku was in, and she would say,
"It can't be, brother. What have you done to this Saiyan?
You're a beast. Now I'll have to do what I never thought of doing."
"Nin, don't do it, please."
Nin would ignore the words of Goku and would say to Colas,
"I will not let you kill him. I'll use my power against someone. I never did this in all my life because I didn't think it would be necessary at some point. But now the circumstances have forced me."
"Sister, are you really serious? Are you planning to confront me and just to protect that Saiyan?" "The hell's wrong with you, sister? Don't you see? This mortal doesn't belong to our demonic race."
"I don't care what you say, brother, with your ignorant thoughts. I really love him, and I don't care that he's not a demon like me."
"So you say you will fight?"
"I don't think you should even ask that question, you idiot."
The Demon King continued to watch the fight, and he was speechless when he saw what his daughter was about to do. He was afraid of what his son would do to his younger sister, Nin, but he wouldn't do anything, because he still felt that the fight of the Saiyan was not over. Meanwhile, Colas realized that his sister really planned to face him, so he would prepare to fight against her. Nin would increase her power and both would start a great battle. Nin was starting to struggle the first few minutes because she never fought in her life. But little by little, her movements were getting better and better. The ordinary demons of that universe would realize that two of the most important figures of their universes were having a fight. This was very surprising for them, so they would be perplexed. They were destroying absolutely everything around them. This fight was creating huge waves that made the planets and stars to be expelled from their orbit. They were creating disorders in the universes, but nothing could be done. This did not really matter to the king. He only wanted to see the fight of the Saiyan, who had fainted. Colas would say to his sister Nin, "I see that you're very powerful, but you know that you won't be able to beat me either.
Don't keep doing it. I don't want to kill you, sister."
At that moment, Goku would wake up and see that Nin was fighting against the demon Colas. This would make Goku angry and he would say,
"No, this can't be. At what moment this guy left me like this? I can't allow to be humiliated this way. I will not allow it. I must do it now. Even though I've not mastered it, it must come out now. That guy will kill us if I don't."
At that moment, Goku would stand up from the ground and the Colas demon would turn around and see that the Saiyan was still alive.
"Ah, but how are you still alive? Don't you get tired? You know you can't do anything. You already tried me, mortal. Now we'll make sure to kill you. Your mistake was to come to this multiverse."
Goku would just look at him without answering him. Nin looked at him and knew immediately what he was going to do. And she would scream at the Saiyan,
"No, Goku, don't do it. You haven't mastered it yet. I told you it was too dangerous."
"Sorry, I must do it."
At that moment, Goku's eyes turned white and he began to release a new unknown power. A transformation that he had not mastered yet. But he took the risk. Goku would make the universe tremble with all that extraordinary power. The demon did not understand what was happening, but he would tell the Saiyan,
"What have you done? Because I'm not able to measure your power. What's wrong? You're starting to bother me a lot, Saiyan."
At that moment, Colas would attack directly to Goku, without warning. But Goku, with little effort, knew how to dodge his attacks. The demon was stunned to see this because minutes ago, with those same movements, he caused a lot of problems to the Saiyan. Goku at that moment would make a small wave of air, which would be enough to make the demon coalesce back.
But what the hell? Why is he so powerful?
Goku, without saying anything, would start hitting this demon, repeating the same thing he had done with him.
I told you that I'd be the one to win this fight, you bastard. You should have stayed where you came from. Now I will end your life.
The Demon King would see this and would be surprised, because he saw that the fight was finally in favor of the Saiyan. Goku ascended to a new state, and he was humiliating his opponent. But suddenly, Neen would say, "No, this can't be happening now." At that moment, Goku would lose his status, not having mastered it, just when he would finish with this guy's life.
"No, but what happened?"
The Demon Colossus would laugh at this and would say to Goku,
"But what happened, Saiyan? I think you're in trouble."
Neen would see this situation and would tell Goku,
"You shouldn't have used it, I told you. Besides, you had enough time to kill him, but instead you preferred to play with him."
Goku was now on the ground, because of the side effects of having used that transformation that he had not yet mastered.
"How stupid I was. I had the opportunity and I wasted it away. What the hell is wrong with me? Why should I always be so trustful?
I really knew that I wouldn't last long with that transformation, but just to humiliate him, I waited a little longer. Now I put everyone's life at risk because of my stupidity." Goku would say this on the ground before he went into a state of paralysis, also because of the transformation. Neen saw that they could no longer do anything, and she had only one option left. But she didn't want to do it because it seemed very cowardly of her, and that would destroy her pride. In the end, even if she didn't want to, she had to do it, and that's what she did. The enemy would be about to launch their attack to kill them, but suddenly, Neen would grab Goku by the arm, and from one second to the next, she had disappeared along with Goku from the scene. Colossus would be very angry by this act, and he would say,
"You're such a coward, sister. I swear I'll find them. I'll kill them instantly, you damn bastards."
Colossus would say this while suddenly, he hears a voice that tells him,
"It seems to me that this will not happen. Refrain from that."
Colossus would be speechless upon hearing this and would say,
"Ah, father, is that you?"
"That's right, son. I've come to finish what I didn't finish that day with you thousands of years ago. I think that Saiyan has already shown too much. No doubt, despite having lost, he showed superiority at some point. Although his confidence has cost him the fight. No doubt I was not wrong to choose him." "Wait, you were watching the fight all this time, father?" "Son, thing is, I didn't eliminate you because I thought you could change. But you're still exactly the same as you were before. You continue to oppose me, and I've already realized that I must eliminate you, son. You've been a total disappointment to the race of demons." "But I'm your own son. You'll still kill me? Really?" "I'm not joking with you, wretch. I've been bad with everyone for millennia. To have a son like you, everyone had asked me to kill you, but I didn't want to do it for the same reason that you're my son. But if I don't set an example, no one will. No one will be allowed to oppose the kingdom, otherwise he will be punished, even if he is my own son. So, father, do you want to fight? I warn you that my powers are not like before. They've increased too much since that day."
Colossus would try to hit his father, without warning, but his father dodged him easily, making the illusion that he had not even moved.
"Son, that Saiyan put you in serious trouble. Are you really capable of thinking that you can fight your own father?"
Colossus at that moment wanted to attack his father with all his power, but he wasn't even able to touch him a little bit. At that moment, his father, with just blinking, made his son be shot from the place and crashed against several objects. Colossus would return and use one of his most special techniques, but this one didn't even have any effect on his father. The Demon King would prepare an attack and would say to Colossus,
"Goodbye, son. I'm sorry about this."
"No, father, what are you doing? Don't do it!"
"This is the end of you."
The Demon King would say at that time that he would launch the attack against his son and eliminate him instantly. It would be a while after this happened. Goku took days to wake up due to the trauma he had for using that transformation without having mastered it, after he almost died and it was hard for Neen to revive him. He had woken up and the first thing he saw was Neen. He'd be surprised and say,
"What is this place?
Damn, Colossus,
you must die!"
Goku would say angrily, but Neen would answer him,
"Goku, my brother has already died. In his fight, you lost your transformation and entered a very strange state.
because of the side effects of having used that transformation.
But what happened to that idiot, Colas? Didn't he kill us?
He couldn't do it because I escaped. I didn't want to do it, but unfortunately I had to. It was more important to save you. If you're wondering where Colas is, don't worry. I found out that my own father eliminated him.
He really did it.
At that moment, Goku would be in a state of confusion. From the beginning, his plan was to kill the Demon King, but he realized that this thought was changing, little by little, more and more in his mind. This idea was moving more and more away from the Saiyan's thoughts. Some time passed, and Nin would tell Goku that his father was planning a union between them, a kind of marriage, but in the way demons do it. Goku, like Nin, was in love, and would accept this request. So he would be informed to his father, these two at the time went to her father, and this united them, through a ritual of blood. This made that Goku now also had the blood of demons, making him a demon, like Nin. So the Saiyan would be half demon and half mortal. Goku would gain new powers by becoming a demon. In the course of time, Goku and Nin had a son, to which they would name him Eren. This one would be born with an immeasurable power. His power was so much that it was even felt by all the universes. Finally, the desire of the Demon King was fulfilled. Even Nin was astonished to see the power of her son Eren. This one counted on a force only compared to that of her father. The Demon King would say, "It's perfect. He'll be my successor." I did not expect to be born with all that power. No demon had been born with all that power before. Eren, everyone will respect you in this universe. When you grow up, you'll be the person that protects the multiverse, and you'll be the one who will put things in order. The son of Goku and Nin was born with a great intelligence, even though he was just a baby. Some years passed and Eren had already grown up. His parents taught him everything he had to know. This had even surpassed the power of his father. But Goku, since his son was born, he had not trained at any time, being busy raising his son. Everyone in the multiverse already knew the child Eren, and all respected him. The Supreme Demons were angry with the Demon King for how he treated the child better than them. These demons became jealous of the child. They would plan to do something very bad with the child Eren. Meanwhile, Goku felt that his son had been taken care of for the necessary time, and that it was time for him to resume his training. And so it would be, Goku would start training with his son. And for the first time, Goku told Eren to attack him with all his power, so Eren would do it without a problem. This boy with a single blow sent his father away, making him crash against some rocks. This fact made Goku realize that his son was overcoming him, and that was because he was not training.
"I'm sorry, son, but I can't allow you to be stronger than me. I'll train and I'll surpass you again."
"We'll see about that, father."
Goku and his son were training, but they did not expect what was about to happen. The Supreme Demons.